So when I did that video the other week about someone hosting a web server on a vape, that encouraged people to send me some other questionable methods of running a server. I might save the Minecraft server running on a phone for another time, but today I wanted to talk about Low Tech Magazine. So the site itself basically has a bunch of low tech solutions for various problems, how to do various old things, how to build things, how people did things in the past, why things being done in the past were a better way to do them, or various other things like that. The site itself is a great read. I would highly recommend you go check it out. And yeah, but I don't want to talk mainly about the content on the site. I want to talk about how the site itself is being run. So you might have noticed this little bit up here. This is a solar-powered website, which means it sometimes goes offline. If we go to that, it takes us to the status page. This says, this website runs on a solar-powered server located in Barcelona and will go offline during longer periods of bad weather. This page shows live data relating to power supply, power demand, and energy storage. So here we have the forecast, so you can know if the upcoming days are going to be reasonable days to generate solar power to power the website. Here we have the general demand of the website. Right now it's been up for almost 3 weeks and 2 days without shutting down, which I would say is pretty good. It currently doesn't have a ton of battery left, but you know, it is 6:40 a.m. CEST, so yeah. Which means that, assuming that something bad doesn't happen in the next little period of time, it survived another night, because there's probably going to be some level of sunlight throughout the day that keeps this server up. Now, when people go to it when this video comes out, I don't know what's going to happen, so yeah. Keep that in mind in case the server might go down. Because I think when this video comes out, it's probably going to be something around 8 p.m. So, we'll see how it goes. The battery meter simply represents the voltage of our battery. For example, a storage capacity of 68% equals 12.68 volts, and a storage capacity of 8% represents 12.08 volts. The voltage reading is the naked data on which each battery meter relies to display a percentage. If you notice right here we have the percentage I was mentioning earlier. It doesn't always correlate with the energy storage capacity because it's also influenced by the electric load, which lowers the voltage, and the solar insulation, which increases the voltage. Because our load, the server, has a rather consistent power use, during the day, our battery meter reflects the local solar conditions. If the panel receives full sun, the voltage will raise above 13 volts, coloring the whole website in yellow. However, if it gets cloudy, the battery meter will decrease and the blue background is revealed. I guess that is blue. I thought it was white, but seeing it now, yes, that actually is a very light shade of blue. I actually kind of like that. More sites should use this shade. During the night, the battery meter reflects the storage capacity of the battery accurately. When the voltage of the battery drops below 12 volts and the whole page is colored in blue, the solar charge controller shuts down the system and the website goes offline. It will come back when the panel receives full sun again. Now, over on this page, the About the Solar Powered website, we have a bit more of an explanation on why this is being done. Because most people probably don't have a solar powered server. Low Tech Magazine questions the belief in technological progress and highlights the potential of past knowledge and technologies for designing a sustainable society. Because a web redesign was long overdue, and because we try to practice what we preach, we decided to build a low tech website that meets our needs and abides by our principles. To reduce energy use, we opted for a back to basics web design using a static site, very based, instead of a data-driven content management system. We further applied default typefaces, dithered images in case you could notice. I don't know how well this is showing on the YouTube video, but they are obviously in black and white or grayscale, if you want to be technically accurate. Offline reading options, those are known as books. So if we go down to the section right here, you can buy the website as a book. Offline reading options. You're not wrong. This is an offline reading option, but it is very funny to refer to a book through that naming. And other tricks to lower energy use far below that of the average website. In addition, the low resource requirement and open design help to keep the blog accessible for visitors with older computers and or less reliable internet connections. Because it uses so little energy, this website can run on a mini computer with the processing power of a mobile phone. It needs 1 to 2.5 watts of power, which is supplied by a small off-grid solar PV system on the balcony of the author's home. Typical for the off-grid renewable power systems, energy storage is limited. This means the website will go offline during longer periods of cloudy weather. And that image I showed you earlier, this is the system in question that is powering everything. It is by no means the craziest system out there, but for running a static website, it seems like it's doing a good enough job. Why a low-tech website? We were told the internet would dematerialize society and decrease energy use. So there is this idea, still kind of does exist, that people would move more things online and not do as much of the real world, more energy consuming things. And it seems like, especially like post-COVID, it's kind of fully reversed and people are fully adopting doing things in person, because who would have known that doing things in person was actually kind of nice? Contrary to this projection, it has become a large and rapidly growing consumer of energy itself. According to the latest estimates, the entire network already consumes 10% of global electricity production, with data traffic doubling roughly every 2 years. I wonder how quickly it's going to take AI to catch up to that. Because I know a lot of people are talking about, like, oh, this AI data center needs to build a nuclear power plant. But, like, at what point does AI get to this point? And at what point is AI at right now? In order to offset the negative consequences associated with high power consumption, renewable energy has been proposed as a means to lower emissions from powering data centers. However, running data centers on renewable power sources is not enough to address the growing energy use of the internet. To start with, the internet already uses 3 times more energy than all wind and solar power sources worldwide can provide. Furthermore, manufacturing and regularly replacing renewable power plants also requires energy, meaning that if data traffic keeps growing, so will the use of fossil fuels. Finally, solar and wind are not always available, and I know some areas have like hydroelectric and things like that, but that's also not available everywhere in the world, which means an internet running on renewable power sources would require infrastructure for energy storage and or transmission that is also dependent on fossil fuels for its manufacture and replacement. Powering websites with renewable energy is not a bad idea, however the trend towards growing energy use must also be addressed. Websites are getting fatter. Websites are way too big for things they don't need to be that big for. Is there any reason why you can't compress your images? Is there any reason why I need to download 30 megabytes to see what could be a basic static website loaded in far less than that? Do you need 10 megabytes of JavaScript? No. No, you don't. The size of the average web page, defined as the average page size of the 500,000 most popular websites, increased from 0.45 megabytes in 2010 to 1.7 megabytes in June of 2018. I am surprised it is still only that small, but it's probably being brought down by a lot of just random small pages that actually don't have much information on them. I am very curious how much, you know, the Apple website ways and things like that, because I can imagine this number probably goes up a lot quicker if you start culling, you know, this to maybe the top 10,000 most popular websites, something like that. For mobile websites, the average page weight rose tenfold from 0.15 megabytes in 2011 to 1.6 megabytes in 2018, because oftentimes there is not a separate mobile page, it is the desktop page rotated and then using some slightly different buttons, but it's still downloading all the same stuff. Heavier or larger websites not only increase energy use in the network infrastructure, but they also shorten the lifetime of computers. The large websites require more powerful computers to access them. This means that more computers need to be manufactured, which is a very energy-intensive process. Always online. wherever you go, you have the internet. No longer do you go to the internet, do you go to a computer and then you access the internet. I can walk around and I have a computer in my pocket. Anywhere I go, there is the internet. Unless I'm in the mountains, maybe. We now live in a world in which no matter where we are always online, including at times via more than one device simultaneously. And it gets even better. We also have a bunch of internet-connected devices that don't need to be internet-connected. For example, smart fridges. Do you need an internet-connected fridge? Do you need the fridge to know what you put in the fridge? No, because you can open the door and look in the fridge like a normal person. Do you need an internet-connected microwave? No. How long are you putting something in the microwave that it really matters? Do you need an internet-connected stove? I guess you could maybe argue that possibly there's some value there so you can control it. You know, you can heat it up as you're walking home, or internet-connected heating, I guess. But, like, you don't need the internet in every single device. Some things are just fine being a regular device. Always on internet access is accompanied by a cloud computing model, allowing more energy efficient use of devices at the expense of increased energy use in data centers, increasing the activities that could perfectly happen offline, such as writing a document, filling a spreadsheet, or storing data, are now requiring continuous network access. Hey, at least we kind of moved past the stage where every video game was introducing always online connectivity. Now, a lot of them are stripping out single player and making the multiplayer kind of the most valuable part of the game, so it kind of recreates that situation anyway. You know, but at least it's not a normal thing usually for single player games. There was a period back in the mid 2010s where basically everyone was doing it. Now, it might seem like a dumb question, but why does the site go offline? Quite a few web hosting companies claim that their servers are running on renewable energy. However, even when they actually generate solar power on site and do not merely offset fossil fuel power use by planting trees, their websites are always online. This means they either have a giant battery storage system on site, which makes their power system unsustainable, or that they are relying on grid power when there's a shortage of solar power, which means they're not actually running 100% on solar power. In contrast, this website runs on an off-the-grid solar power system with its own energy storage, and will go offline during longer periods of cloudy weather. Less than 100% reliability is essential for the sustainability of an off-the-grid solar system, because above a certain threshold, the fossil fuel energy used for producing and replacing the batteries is higher than the fossil fuel energy saved by the solar panels. Apart from sustainability and costs, the author's home has limited space for installing solar panels and batteries. Keeping the server online no matter what, the standard business model of web hosting companies simply requires too many batteries. And for a website like this, if it goes offline every so often, it's not really that big of a deal, right? You can't really sell that to big corporate users who want 100% reliability where being down for an hour costs a couple million dollars. So with that in mind, how often does it go offline? Over a period of roughly 1 year, for some reason it didn't go the entire year, from 12th of December 2018 to 28th of November 2019, the server was up for 95.26% of the time. This means they're offline for 399 hours, which sounds like a lot, but over the entire year, is not that much. It's only 16 days. Of course, this is not exactly viable for a lot of systems, but it's pretty good. Those numbers don't tell the whole story, though. During the first 10 months of this period, the server was online for 98.2% of the time. This means we're offline for only 152 hours, 6.4 days, and this includes the winter months. But a Linux kernel upgrade caused a bit of a problem, causing the average power use of the server to go from 1.19 to 1.49 watts, which normally wouldn't be that much. But when you're running this much of a tight ship, is definitely going to affect you. This is the average power usage of the server. Throughout most of the year, it was totally fine. And then all of these points here, you see massive drops to zero. The massive drops to zero are when the server was going offline every single night. And you can see right around here, the darker line just shoots up a tiny little bit, enough that things went completely haywire. So with the fact the site can sometimes go down, when is the best time to visit the website? Well, during the day would be the best answer here, but we're also gonna say a lot more than that. The day is a good enough answer. Because it is solar powered, the website is most often online during the summer. To help visitors plan their visits to Low Tech Magazine, we provide them with several pointers. So there's obviously the battery meter I showed you earlier, and there's also the statistics dashboard, which is where I showed you where it has the forecast, it has the power demand, all this good stuff. For some reason, it's not loading the power usage. Not entirely sure why. I'm gonna reload the page. That's broken. Okay, I don't know why that's not working. It was working just fine earlier. This is a really weird website. I don't know why this exists. Like, it's a cool idea. And do I think most people are gonna run a website like this? No. Do I think most people should run a website like this? If you want the website to be online all the time, no. But do I think it's really cool? And do I really enjoy seeing people do things like this when it's an option, to do so? Absolutely yes. And as with the vape video, if you have any ideas for me to talk about, please send them my way. I am more than happy to learn about weird, interesting ideas that are out there. Yeah. That's basically it. So if you liked the video, go like the video, go subscribe as well. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Dudley Barapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I am solar powered.